Hi, welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to continue the topic called contiguous allocation operating system. And we have to see advantages and disadvantages of the continuous allocation also. The previous session I explained about the file allocation methods, what is what. Today we are going to see elaborately see the topic. The motto of presentation means here now what is what and how continuous allocation support the operating system concept. And at last, with the example as well as advantages and also disadvantages, or you can say merits and demerits of this concept here. So, continuous allocation method. So, before going that, you had now what is about allocation methods? Allocation methods are methods where it is helpful and say about how to allocate disk space for the OS here, how to allocate the disk space for the operating system here. There is a overall concept of allocation method concept here. And here the main memory has to accommodate both the OS and the user space, and the user space has to accommodate various user processes also here. And also we had now many things here, and we had now what is maybe contiguous allocation, and is a allocation is a one where we can say is a one of the memory management technique for technique where whenever there is a request by the user process for the memory, and also single section of the continuous memory block is given to that process based on the requirements, where you can simply is one of the memory management technique. And also here the space allocated continuously, not scattered, that means continuously allocated. A file request length is the size is somewhat, and the length is 5 means it continues to allocate the blocks. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. And also how it's achieved, it is achieved by the memory into fixed size partitions or variable size partition. Most of the time we are following the fixed size partition only. So before going to technical now everything, we have now idea about what is fixed size partition and the variable size partition. In fixed size partition, what happens means the memory is divided into fixed size blocks, and each block contains exactly one process only. Okay, remember. And also in your variable size partition, opposite the one, that means here the OS maintains a table that contains the information about all the memory spots that are occupied by the processes, and all memory spots are the half all the memory spots that are still available for the process here. So we have about what is a fixed size partition as well as the variable size partition here. So before going, and also we had now about the scheme called multiple multiple partition allocation here. I'm going to use a pointer here. So memory allocation, multiple partition allocation, we will deeply see here. I'm going to use a pointer here. So here one of the multiple partition allocation here is one of the method for allocating memory that is also following. That means what? Divide memory into several fixed size partitions. Okay, part of the memory you can divide into several fixed size partitions. For example, the memory size is 16, we can make fixes 15, 10 plus 5 plus 1 and so on like that. And also is involved with the degree of multiprogramming, and also when the process terminates, the partition becomes available for another process also. Remember. And also this method was originally used by the IBM OS 360. And in this scheme, what will happen exactly is OS keeps a table indicating which part of the memory are available and which are occupied. So there will be a table issue with clarity. And so also here, the initially the all memory is available for user processes and is considered one large block of available memory. And also here, memory is allocated to processes until finally the memory requirements of the next process cannot be satisfied. Let's go for the example. And before going to the example right now, how OS allocates the whole tier process? Question arises now. How OS allocates a whole tier process? Okay, generally, the memory blocks available comprise a set of block holes of various sizes scattered throughout the memory. Remember, and also whenever a process arrives and needs memory, the system searches the set of hole that is large enough for this process. If the hole is too large, it's split into two parts. One part is allocated to the arriving process, and other is returned to the set of the holes. And also, when a process terminates, it releases its block of memory, which is then placed back in the set of holes here. So let's see, go for the example, you'll get more clarity. Say there'll be a figure, example for a contiguous allocation here, let's assume that there will be directory concept three entries here by default. This is called file, another entry called start, another entry called here. So this is the disk. So you have disk to go deeply in port as well, secondary memory and so on. So here is a disk that is having the blocks like this. Let's assume that we have file one. The file one starting the block is zero and then this port. So as the name implies, it takes continuously the block zero, it occupies then 1, 2, 3 like that. Next one is it won't go forward because next file to have yeah, file to where it starts from the location of file and then to 3. So it takes 3 blocks continuously, that is start from the 5, then it occupies 6 and 7 also. The 9 is the next file number 3. Similarly, starting length is 9 and length is 5. So totally 9 to 14 occupy like that. That is 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So like that will be the remember directory is a directory concept three entries, files start and length. Let's go for the explanation here, some explanation. What you understand from here means here every allocation methods maintain a directory in which contains the information about address of the file back here. Moreover, similarly in this method, we have a directory which contains the starting address and the length of the four files. That is file one, file two, file three, file four onwards. Just now shown here. And also the advantage of this mechanism what? OS does not have to scan the complete main memory. It can refer to the directory to find the required file location and then search for the file required information in the particular file. Then now when the first file says file one, let's assume that the file's one having size of 8 KB, then the OS divides the file into 4 equal parts. Okay, that is called 2 KB, that is 2 KB plus 2 KB plus 2 KB plus 2 KB. These are stored in the memory block like 0100, 0101, 0102, 0103 onwards. Moreover, so here what you understand and come to conclude here. So when the OS finds the address of the first file block from the directory, then it can search for the sequentially placed file block to find the required information. So I hope that you understand the concept of continuous memory location, continuous allocation. Let's go for advantages and disadvantages. Here, advantages what you can mean here is always easy to implement and faster memory access. And support both direct and sequence access and memory minimal seek time. Moreover, you have to know the goal or motive of these allocation methods, whether it is continuous or non-continuous or whatever the linked allocation method, because this will see in the upcoming session, linked allocation lecture. The overall motive is what to retrieve the data, to retrieve the information or file. What are the file you want to retrieve? You should be efficiently retrieve the file from the disk. That is important. What are the files? Disadvantages, you can say, wastage of memory space, suffer from both internal and external for fragmentation, and the file has to be initialized at time of creation only, and file size cannot grow as well as pre-initialized. The previous video session I explained about separately what is internal fragmentation and external fragmentation. You can check it in the free time. These are about continuous allocation method. If any queries or suggestions, please kindly communicate with the social media, what are going to be in the description. And if you like the video, please share and subscribe and share it with your friends. Thank you. Share it with your friends. Thank you.